Hello friends and family, you're welcome back to Netcode-Hub channel. This video, we are going to talk about how to style applications, that's a .NET MAUI applications using XAML, XAML file. You know, styling is very important in app development. When you develop your application, definitely you must make the application look nice. And for an app to look nice, you have to style it. So let's talk about styles. Now, there are four types of style in .NET MAUI, especially that is XAML. The first one, we have the inline style, we have explicit, we have implicit, and we have a global style. Let's talk about these one after the other. Now, when we talk about inline style, an example in the page here clarifies what I'm talking about. Let's see, now I've created a new project, and this is a boilerplate. You can see when you create a new MAUI project, this is all you have. Now, if I go to Solution Explorer, you can see we have main page, .xaml. If I open it, you can see we have an inline style. So if I talk about height request, horizontal options, and all these are font size, these are all inline style. So any style that is added to a view within the context here, it is an inline style. So we can decide to create another label and I add a style. Let's see. We can decide to create, let's say, frame here. Now, this frame, we can add a style as border color as red. So if I do this, it's an inline style, and I can talk about maybe width request as 200 and height request at 200. So all these are styles. Now, let's see. Let's put label in. Okay, so let's put label, and now let's say the text for this label is inline style. So let's grab this frame and put into this vertical stack layout. So save this. And let's see, so we have our frame. Okay, so we must cut this. It shouldn't be here. It must. So let's put it on top of this image. So we have to save this, and you can see we have this over here. So that is the inline style. So a style that is appended to the view within the context or the content page. That's the inline style. Now let's talk about the global style. Now you can see all these views, they have a global style. As soon as you create a MAUI project or MAUI app project, you have this style added. And they have grouped them into a one file known as styles.xml. When you go to Solution Explorer, you can see resources and go to styles. You can see you have the styles file. Now, all these are global styles. So you can see a style is appended to button. Now, if I go to live preview, this button here, and that is the size. So font size is 14. I can increase this to 19 and see what's going to happen. You can see the 19, it has changed to what? Bigger. I can reduce the same thing. Now, I talk about corner radius. I can set the corner radius to 20 and see what's going to happen. So that is the 20 here. Now, if I save this and I come to this page and I try to add another button. So let's add another button here. And now let's set this button text to, let's say, global star. Now see what happens. You can see the radius has also changed because this is a global. So global style affects all the styles that we are going to, all the view that we are going to take. So we can do that in the styles.xaml. Okay, let's go back to the normal one, that is the 8. Also, what we can do here is, you see these styles here, we can also copy the same style and now move it to the page here and now put it on top. Now, how do you do that? Now, with the using of this global style, we can override this global style. So let's see how to override that. We can do that in the page here. So on top here, we can specify content. So content page. Then here we can talk about dot resources. Then in here, we can talk about resource dictionary. And as you can see, we can have style. So this style, we can specify the target type, and we want to use as button. So that's the target type as button. And in here, this is what we can do. We can have set setter. So this setter, we can specify the property here that you want to use. So let's assume you want to change the border or corner radius. So let's say you want to use corner radius. And now here we can specify the value here as 20. Okay. Now let's save this. And I will see all of these corner radius have changed to 20. Let's set to 50. And now let's see, so that is 50. You see? So let's set to 100. Now let's see what's going to happen. Now if I set this to 1, and that is 10. Okay. This is 50. Good. You see? So although you have the global style set here in the tiles file where it has 8, but we are overriding that in the content page. So that is a global style. So even though we have global style set in the file, you can still override it in the content page by specifying the content page resources, resource dictionary, style, and specify the target type as a view. Then you can now set the property with 8 value. Okay, now let's go to the next one. That is, now if we spoke about the inline, the global, now let's say the implicit style. How do you do the implicit style? Now, implicit style, you can override the style in a content page. And you know, when you do this, that is called the implicit style. So when you override the content page, or when you override the global style inside the content page, that is known as the implicit. So there's an implicit. So if this is an implicit, then what is the last one that is known as the explicit file? Now with the explicit, you can create your style for any of the target type, that is any view in the resource folder or the resource file or the style file. You know, we have the style file over here, and you can create. So instead of creating this over here, we are going to copy this style and I move it to the styles file here and paste it over there. We give it a name and we can assign the style inside the view. Let's see how to work on this. So this style, let's go to our main page. Now let's grab this style here. Okay, so let's close. Let's clear all this. So when you save this, we're going to have the normal one from the global settings. So let's see. Okay, now we save this. You have the button, and when we check the styles here, we have the one as what corner radius value of 8. Okay, so when you run this application again, you're going to work fine. Let's do that and see if you're going to create it. So as you can see, we have the default one, that is a corner radius of 8. Now let's come to the style.xml file. Now here you can see we have a style and the target is activity indicator. You see we have the target as well, indicator view. So in here, we are going to also specify our own. So how do you specify our own? Let's say this is, let's give it a name as, so this is customized style. So let's comment this. And now what we copied from the content page, let's paste this here. So we are creating maybe a style for a button. Okay. You know, we have a button target style already. That's the global one. It's over there. But here we are creating a style for a button here. You see we have this button already. But what we can do here is the target here is for button, and we have the same button. Okay, you can see the key is already defined in the scope. So what can we do to differentiate this style from this? We can do that by giving it a name. That is the global one. So we don't want to use the global one. We want to specify our own. In doing that, we can use the key. So X, then use a key. The key is like a name. So let's say this is BTN1. This is button one. So with this, we can now go to, let's save this. And we want to use corner radius of 50. So let's come to the page here. And now let's add this button. So how do you use, or how can you use a style from our XAML or style page? So let's specify styles here. And now these styles, we are going to specify X and the static resource. So this static resource, we are going to find, we see the BT1 over here. So only this button is going to have that radius of 50. Let's save this. XAML view. Now you see we have this button specified as what? Only 50. Aside from this, we can also create an inheritance in style. You can create another style here. So this also for button. And I'm going to say this is button two. And it's going to inherit from this. So I'm going to say from on top here, I'm going to say based on. So this is inheritance. Okay. So based on, then we're going to specify this button name. So let's say X static resource. And you're going to say it is from this BTN1. So we are inheriting all the styles in the BTN1 here. And we want to add our own style. So we have the corner radius already. So let's specify maybe background color. So let's specify background color. And now the value here, you want to set it to maybe green. Okay, let's save this. Now you have two styles here, BTN1 and BTN2. Let's go to our main page. So let's use this button. Now let's copy this and paste it again here. Now inside of this BTN1, we're going to say BTN2. And let's save this and see. So we're going to have the same radius off. So let's see. Oh, okay. So we have to move this button. Or we can just copy this one and now paste it here. So we have to close it. Okay. So save this. And like we see, we have two buttons. So let me open it here. You can see we have these two buttons here. Now one has a background of green, but the same radius, because this green one is inheriting from the base one that is this. You see? So that is a way of using styles in XAML. So you see, we spoke about four types. The inline style, styling within. We have the global style. That is when the style, we overwrite what we have in the styles.xaml file, the default one. We spoke about the implicit one. That is when you overwrite the global style inside the main or the content page here. And we have the explicit, you customize your own style by giving it an S key name, then utilize it in your content page as this. I believe this is clear. So that is it for this video. If you like what I'm doing, you can give me a thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel also. Check the playlist. We have a lot of videos and lessons about the both projects and the single lessons. You can take them for .NET MAUI, Blazor WebAssembly or Blazor Server videos. That is it for this video. Thank you so much for watching, and I'm going to catch you up in the next video.